Greetings, cyberdogs and citizens of the internet! This is Rendog coming at you from the streets of Mole City in this Let's Play Minecraft Survival series. In the previous episode, we were preparing the butthole for the delivery of a baby butler. And in this episode, guys, we are going to be finding a spot to put our brewing stand. Because before we can even think of making a butler, we need to be able to cure an infected villager. And that means that we need a brewing stand to make a weakness potion, which is one of the ingredients that we need to cure an infected villager. Of course, our spawner is going to make the infected villager. We are going to isolate the infected villager, which is what we did in the previous episode, designing a way to isolate that villager. And then we are going to be curing that villager, and he or she should hopefully just run straight into the butler's house over here and claim this house as his own. So what I thought we would do today, guys, is go somewhere that we haven't been for a while, and that is that area just between the mole hole and the nether portal temple. That is, of course, where I want to make the witch's cave, and that is where I want the brewing stand to sit. So what we're going to be doing today is using some TNT. Is dynamite. A TNT is dynamite. to blow open a hole into the side of that mountain so that we can get a brewing stand up in that witch's cave. Basically, we're going to be starting on excavating what will eventually become the witch's cave. Now, what's happened over the last 10 or so episodes or so is, as usual, I've become very unorganized, and things are starting to sort of this is a health and safety fail if I ever did see one, man. It's almost impossible to get into the lakeside villa now. That is just there we go. All right, we definitely need to sort that out at some point. But guys, as I was saying, everything has become a little bit unorganized up in Rentopia, and I'm not sure where all my gunpowder is. So I'm just going to be going around all of the places in Rentopia today looking for gunpowder and looking for sand. I've got some sand, but I'm not sure if it's going to be enough sand to achieve our goal. Let's have a look if there's a minecart down here that we can take. Yes, there is. Let's head over to the strip mine outpost, because we actually haven't been there in a long ass time. And I'm hoping that there will be some gunpowder in the storage rooms in the strip mine outpost. But guys, today what we're going to be doing is excavating a hole into the side of basically what was the original mountain of the mole hole. And hopefully we're going to be able to find a nice open space there that we're going to be able to make a witch's cave. Now, this witch's cave has got to be damp, it's got to be moist, it's got to be disgusting, man. It's got to be an absolutely nasty place to be. But, you know, I want vines and mushrooms and mossy cobblestone and all of that jazz all up in there, man. I think I'm gonna pick up some cobblestone while I'm here, because we have quite a lot of cobblestone here in the strip mine outpost, which is sweet. Let's just go through these chests, guys, and see if we can spot any sand or any gunpowder, because those are the materials that we need today to do some freaking explosions, man. Damn, I'm so excited to start blowing some stuff up. It's been a while since we've actually played with some dynamite, so I am excited. And what we're going to have to do is take a cart all the way back to Grand Molehole Station. It's been a while, actually, since we just sort of casually traveled around, you know, Rentopia. We've been so focused on making Mole City and working on the butler's house that we haven't Come on, press the button. Come on. Come on. Come on, baby. You can do it. Come on. You can do it. There we go. There we go. And kaplooey. Sweet. You know, we've been so focused on working on the butler's house and working on Mole City that we haven't really been wandering around our world at all. And, you know, Rentopia is starting to become really sweet. So, you know, I want to start traveling around these parts a little bit more just to sort of experience what we've been building. You know, it's pointless making all of this stuff if you don't get to enjoy it. So, you know, I was going to sort of collect all the gunpowder without you guys, but I thought, you know what? Why don't we just take a nice little train ride around Rentopia, have a look at what we've done, and, you know, it's kind of like a tour, but not a tour. You know what I'm saying? And I think, I mean, there's got to be some gunpowder in the mole hole, man. Right, that one's going to go all the way back to the strip mine outpost, so that is sweet. Let us check the butthole first to see if there is any gunpowder in this chest. Ooh, hello. Okay, well, this is where all the gunpowder is at. Looks like we've got two stacks of 60 fell, plus 28, and it sounds to me like the butthole is delivering as usual. Now, guys, what we spoke about in the previous episode was trying to figure out which of the zombies are actually infected villagers. And I've had a look at what the texture pack looks like for an infected villager for this texture pack. And some of you guys have told me in the comment section below that what an infected villager looks like in this texture pack is a normal zombie, but he has a much bigger nose. So at the moment, we can't actually see these zombies' faces. So we could actually be killing infected villagers off here. So what I wanted to do was come over here and add just a thing of glass over here. It means that the mobs are going to be able to see us, but we will now be able to see if a zombie is an infected villager or just a normal zombie, you know, in the butthole over here. And of course, if it is an infected villager, we're going to drop him down there into the curing facility, I guess is what we're going to call it. The infested villager hospital, I guess is the best way to describe it. So that is a normal zombie. That is not an infected villager. I mean, the chances of us getting an infected villager now are probably really slim. Hey, dude. No, that looks like a normal zombie. So we'll just be coming back here, you know, periodically to come and check if we have found, you know, if we have actually spawned an infected villager. And the day that happens, man, it is going to be a freaking happy day. Oh, man, I can't wait for that to happen. Right, let's head up into my bedroom to check my chest in the bedroom to see if we've got any more gunpowder or sand up in here. Let's have a look. No, we do have a whole bunch of awesome jazz in here, though. So nothing in there. We've got absolutely... Oh, there's a couple of gunpowders over there. So we'll take those. Thank you very much. And I think what we forgot to do was actually check the foreman's house or the foreman's quarters in Mole City. We may have done it, but I don't know. Let's go back and have a look quickly. Oh, there's also a chest underneath in the Mole City sewerage system. So we'll go check out that chest too, man. This is kind of like a World of Warcraft grinding mission. You know, your mission is to collect 2 stacks of sand. Oh, there's some sand. Nice. Okay, what else have we got in here? We got some steaks up in here. That is awesome. Whole bunch of urn. We got an ender pearl. That is good. Man, there is some sweet stuff in this chest, man. Look how much stuff you can just gather by working on a big project. Which map is this? I'm so curious. Let's have a look at this map. Right, what map are we looking at here? Oh, this is the map of Mole City, but the corner of it. You can see it. It's now updating itself. And you can see the foundations of Mole City starting to look really cool. You can see the trees. You can see the little side roads. That is sweet. That is very sweet. But that is not what we're dealing with today, guys. We need to find ourselves a little bit more sand. Why don't we head down into the sewage systems to see if there's any sand in this chest down here. I definitely need to make some sort of like manhole or something to be able to get into the sewage systems without having to come down into the poisonous Mole City lake over here. Right, nothing in here of interest except some glass. We'll definitely pick up that glass. Glasses, you know, we're actually running out of sand. We're running out of glass. We're going to have to go on some sort of a glass quarrying mission at some point. I can't believe, actually, that we are so low on sand. But sand seems to be quite a required resource in Minecraft. It's like one of those resources that you don't think you're going to need a lot of. But then, you know, as soon as you start working and as soon as you start building, like, really big projects, you suddenly realize how important sand is. Nothing in that chest. I mean, all we can do now is head into the storage rooms and have a look if there's anything in the storage rooms. Let's have a look in the sand and glass. Ooh, hello, there is some sand. Sweet. And let's go to the mob loot drop chest, which is this one, to see if there's any more gunpowder. 3 more gunpowder in there, so that is awesome. And that means that we probably have more than enough sand and gunpowder to make some TNT. Is down, oh man. I can't even remember if there is a chest over here. Let's have a look. No, I moved the chests from that area quite a long time ago, I think. It's been a while since we've been in here. My goodness, I don't even know where we're going to start. But I think let's take this one step at a time, my friends. Why don't we start by making some TNT first? And let's see if I can remember how we do this. I think it is like this. Yeah, that is how you make the TNT. That is how you make the explosions. Right, so let's just evenly spread this sand up in here, just like this. And now we can evenly spread our gunpowder. Man, I can't believe how much gunpowder we've been accumulating from the butthole. I mean, I've been grinding that butthole pretty hard, I gotta say. It has been put through its paces, shall we say. It certainly has been delivering for the last week or so. I haven't been gentle, so to speak. But I think that's probably more than enough TNT than we actually need. So why don't we... I'm just so freaking excited about finding an infected villager. My curiosity is just taking over here, guys. I really just want to come back and check if an infected villager has dropped. And looks like we've got a couple of skeletons. Got a creeper up in there. Creeper! Hang on, that creeper is looking precarious, man. He's going to take an arrow to the creeper bits. And this zombie, let's see his face. Nope, it just looks like normal run-of-the-mill bog-standard zombie. That's probably insulting to all zombie kind. Sorry, guys, I'm not a zombie-phobe. Well, I am a bit of a zombie-phobe. I do hate zombies. They smell. They often try and hit you with bits of string for some reason. For some reason, a string is like a really powerful item to a zombie. No idea why. Okay, so anyway, guys, here we are, right? We still need to do a little bit of work over here too to finish the roof of the Nether Portal Temple. I'm not sure if I've ever brought you guys up here, so why don't we just have a quick look up here while we're on this little bit of a tour, I guess. Oh man, it is so sweet up here. I still need to finish this side of it too. What the jazz? There is a zombie and a creeper in this little thing over here, man. You are messing with my zombie spawner spawn rates, you bastards. Take an arrow to the brain. Bam! And is this an infected zombie? Infected villager? Nope. It ain't. Alright, let's make sure we get a torch up in here, man. These little areas here... Oh, and there's some gunpowder. Don't mind if I do. These little areas are actually slowing down the spawn rate of our mob spawner. So let's just make sure this is torched up and that nothing can spawn in here. Okay, awesome. Right, let's get back to business, guys. We are digging out the area that is eventually going to become the Witch's Cave. And it is going to be inside this area over here. In fact, it is going to be all up in this jazz over here. And as I explained when I was working on the Nether Portal Temple, what I want to do is kind of have like a natural window over here that looks out over Mole City from the Witch's Cave, as well as looking this way toward the graveyard and toward, I mean, in this direction, all the way in this direction is actually Wren Town. So I think, you know, the views will be really awesome. And I thought about, you know, making sort of natural walls of glass that would complement the contours of the mountain face. To make the Witch's Cave look like kind of like a modern day Witch's Cave, right? It's going to be like a moist, damp, viney, mushroomy cave, but it will also have these awesome modern ass windows in it. So, you know, I think that is kind of what I'm going for over here. And I think what we should probably do is start by just blowing up some stuff. You know, you can never go wrong with a bit of TNT to the face of a mountain. And I mean, I don't even know where to start. Well, I mean, number one, we need flint and steel before we can even think about blowing anything up. So let's head back into the storage rooms. Get ourselves some flint and steel. Should be in the toolbox over here right at the end. I'm starting to know exactly where my stuff is now after, what, 181 episodes. And I now know where all of my jazz is, kind of. Mostly. And I think in season 3, one of my big aims is going to be to make a brand new storage facility, like a warehouse, right? Like a massive warehouse. And maybe even so massive that each item or each important item in this game will have its own chest, for example. And that way we can really start, you know, accumulating large amounts of materials and get really, really rich with materials. Okay, so guys, what I'm thinking here, right, is because we don't want to place TNT on this level because we're going to be wasting it then. We want to probably place TNT up on this level over here. So what I'm thinking is, why don't we get up to this position up here? And then we can start excavating this way into the actual center of this mountain face. And then I think what we'll do is just start, you know, when we blew up the mountainside for the Nether Portal Temple, we did like a controlled explosion, you know, it was like a controlled TNT explosion. I laid TNT all the way from here, all the way to the end of the mountain face and did a sort of controlled blast. And that was pretty sweet, but I think in this case, we want the Witch's Cave, the contours of the Witch's Cave to be like jagged and messed up and look really natural. And I think the best way to do that is just to literally place TNT organically, if you will, and hope for the best, basically. Hope that the TNT is going to sort of naturally blow up nice spaces inside this witch's cave. So I think what I'm going to do is place a TNT over here, then two blocks away, because remember, if you want to chain TNT, it's got to be sort of two blocks away. I think it can actually work three blocks away, but it's a bit temperamental. It doesn't always trigger three blocks away. So these days I just tend to go two blocks away. And I think what I'm going to do is sort of do like an X shape over here, right? So let's put another bit over there, and then we'll come around to the back of this bit of TNT over here. Now we better get some torchage up in here before nasty things start to spawn. Let's get around the back over here of this bit of TNT. I think it's probably, it's in there, right? Oh god. Whew, man, I just panicked there. I thought that maybe, just maybe, pickaxing the TNT would set it off, and that would have been bad times, and most certainly would have resulted in death. Okay, so here is a wall. I'm assuming that this is the mob spawner. Let's break in here and have a look. What are we working with over here? Okay, so there's a piece of wood over here. This should break into... Man, where the heck are we? What is this? Oh my goodness, this is actually the butthole over here. We have just broken into the butthole. Okay, so now we've got our bearings. Now we kind of know how far our TNT wants to go. We definitely don't want to put any more TNT in this direction, or we're going to blow up the butthole. As funny as that might be. Whoa, that dude is wearing some pimpin' armor, man. Damn, oh, maybe we'll get our golden chest plate now from this. Take him down to Chinatown. Oh, guys, one of you Cyberdogs gave me such an amazing idea. I do believe it was an idea from the Cyberdog Web Bling Kid. And he mentioned that... Oh, another helmet. Sweet. Let's look at your face. Show me your ugly face, bastard. Show me your face. No, that is just a normal zombie. Oh man, that's another helmet. Anyway, there was a Cyberdog called Web Bling Kid, and he gave me such an awesome idea. He said, why don't you name the armor set, the gold armor set that you are getting from the butthole, armor of the butthole. How awesome is that? So, you know, like the chest plate would be like chest plate of the butthole, and the helmet would be like, you know, skull cap of the butthole. It awakened the 10-year-old in me, man, and I was like, hell yeah, I'm definitely going to be calling that golden armor the armor set of the butthole, and it's going to be sweet. Okay, cool, guys, so I've made a configuration here of, 1, 2, 3, 4 TNTs, and I think I want to put one more down below, just underneath, over there. Well, I was going to. Okay, we don't actually need to do it there, and then let's put one more, two, three. Let's put one more over here. This will be the trigger one, right? And that should blow open a nice open, huge open hole into the witch's cave. Let us get our safety helmets on, people. Hard hats on, please. Actually, I don't even have my hard hat on. So before we even blow this up, guys, I need to get my safety gear on. And it's actually ironic because, you know, the yellow suit that we made, our construction suit that we made for making Mole City, is actually has quite a lot of blast protection enchants on it. So it's actually the perfect choice when working with TNT. So let's get all of our gear on. Let's have a look, man. Oh, I'm looking a pimp. I am ready to blow some jazz up, man. Let's do this thing. I hope you guys are ready, man. I hope you got your earplugs, your hard hats, and everybody step away from the molehole. Things are about to get freaking sparkly up in this jazz. And hopefully we're not going to break anything. But only time will tell. Dude, you are not welcome here. Man, he is burning in the nether temple. That is awesome. All right, let's do this, guys. Oh, wait, this is the wrong level, right? Here we go. All right, let's do this thing. Whew, okay, dear Lord of Minecraft, please don't blow up any of my jazz. Kaplaya! Boom! Oh, man. That was awesome. That was actually... That couldn't have gone more perfect. Look at this, guys. This is exactly what I'm talking about. Look at this. We've got this sort of natural contour over here. The sort of natural contours of a cave. And then over here is literally going to be the window looking over Mole City. Oh my goodness, that actually turned out so freaking well. Absolutely 100% stoked with that. It came pretty close to blowing up the butthole over here though, so that's, we've got to watch for that for the next round of TNT. But let's take care of the butthole over here, guys. This place is full up like nobody's business. This dude's got a helmet on. Oh, he picked up the helmet. He picked up that helmet and put it on, man. I'm just checking for infected villagers. Doesn't look like an infected villager. You, I actually can't see your face, man. Back up a bit, son. Back up. No, you do not look like an infected villager. And thanks for the helmet. Not enchanted, unfortunately. All right, sweet. So, the cave is, looks like it's open in this direction, which is most excellent. We could probably go a few more blocks in this direction, though. So, why don't we sort of get to the middle of the... Let's get a torch up in here first, though. Just... there is something in the mole hole. I heard you. Don't think I didn't hear you, spider. Bam! Bam! These are like traps, man. Like as soon as you hear the jingling of these pressure plates, you know that something is in your mole hole. If you know what I'm saying. Okay, so let's go this way, guys. Let's dig in this direction. I think that I'm actually not sure how far the mountain face goes. So why don't we just dig all the way through, and that'll give us a general idea of how big of an explosion we need to make now to get all the way through to the other side of the witch's cave. Okay, so there, let's just get our, let's get Paw back into our hand. Man, Paw has been doing the business. Look how much dirt he's broken, and he has hardly taken any damage at all. So as you can see, the view is going to be really epic from this side of the witch's cave also. And it looks like we've got sort of, let's have a look. Let's do this like this, right? So two from the front. The first bit of TNT is going to go over there, right? Bam! One, two. Second piece of TNT over there. One, two. Third piece of TNT up in there. And what we'll do is, I think, why don't we add TNT over here to this one. Kaplooey! And right up in here. So now we're going to get another nice big explosion. I think we should also probably put one above this one so that we can open up toward the roof a bit. I want the roof to be quite high, and I want... you know, I want like vines and stuff to be dangling off the roof. So I need the roof to be quite high so that we can make sort of stalactite type, or is it stalagmite? I never know which one it is, which one hangs from the ceiling. But we can make those things. Let's have a look. So one, two, needs to be up in this jazz like this. All right, there we go, sweet. Okay, so second round of splosions are about to occur. Hard hats on. Earplugs in, please, people. Let's do this thing. I'm gonna back up a bit. Bam! Ooh, ooh. Ooh. Man, we took some pain over there. Damn. I hope we didn't break any of our armor. Oh my goodness. Okay, our leather boots are almost on the way out. But that probably went a little bit better than I wanted it to. This is literally blown all the way out. Okay, but that is looking pretty good, actually. I'm happy with that. I think what we probably need to do is get a bit of TNT up in here, just to open up this space a bit over here. So why don't we just dig a little bit in, and probably one more, actually. One more space, and let's get some light up in here. Let's get our TNT in there. Oops, no, wait. That is way too much TNT. Alright, let's do this. Bam! Run! Sweet. And I think we're probably going to have to do a little bit of excavating just to clear out all the space, but I think probably we want another bit of TNT over here. Mining with TNT, man, it's an art. Kaplooey! Man, I love the sound of TNT exploding. It is just, it's a beautiful sound. What have we uncovered here, man? I thought we'd like broken into a cave or something. Okay, so there is the floor of the Dogolith courtyard right above us. So now we know how high we need to come. Probably what we need to do is put another bit of TNT over here, I would say. Run! Boom! And right about here, I reckon. Run! Oh! My bad. Whew, damn. Okay, awesome, awesome. This is so awesome. Okay, this is looking good, guys. I am loving how the Witch's Cave is starting to turn out. The TNT is doing exactly what I wanted to by making sort of very natural looking spaces inside this cave. You know, this cave is starting to look really natural, and I love it, man. The brewing stand is going to probably sit somewhere in the middle, down there somewhere. Now, I don't know if to make it actually above here or down here to make this... You know, maybe that's what we need to do. Maybe we need to have like a really nice entrance into the Nether Portal Temple down here. So we make this corridor really, really nice. And then above the corridor can be the Witch's Cave. You know, my idea was to make this whole area the Witch's Cave, but that might just be a little bit too big. I'm kind of, I kind of like the fact that the Witch's Cave is sort of hidden. And maybe the only way to get here is via like a secret entrance. You know, like in Lord of the Rings, like the entrance to that giant spider's house. In the side of the mountain, or Sheba, or whatever her name is, you know, like to get to the Witch's Cave, you've got to go through like a small pass or something. It's not easily accessible via the molehole. It's kind of hidden. It's kind of ancient, and I think I kind of like that vibe, man. But this is looking kind of cool now. I'm pretty happy with this. I think what I'm going to do is probably just clear this out a little bit, flatten the floor a bit, get a floor down, and think about whether or not to have a corridor and a Witch's Cave, or just to combine the corridor with the Witch's Cave. In fact, guys, this is a perfect opportunity for you guys to hit me in the comments section below, man. What do you guys think? How should we make this Witch's Cave? Should the Witch's Cave be one giant area that fills in this mountain? Or should we have the Witch's Cave above a really nice looking corridor that takes you to the Nether Portal Temple? That is the question of the week, my friends. So get your answers in the comment section below, or why don't you go check out dogcraft.net, guys, the official CyberDog fan community. Maybe what we can do is put a thread into Dogcraft talking about where the Witch's Cave could sit, and I am going to be going through all of your guys' comments and ideas. But guys, I tell you what, man, we are over time for this episode, because you know, we've been playing with TNT, and whenever we play with TNT, we spend far too much time blowing stuff up than we should. So guys, I'm going to end the episode here. I just want to thank you all for freaking watching this, man, and thank you all for the amazing support that you all have been giving me on YouTube and on dogcraft.net. Some of you guys know that I'm going through a bit of a tough time at the moment, and you know, all of the love and all of the freaking amazing support that you guys are giving me is really helping me out and helping me get through this. So thanks to everybody. You know who you all are, and man, I cannot wait to get on to the next episode where we're going to be working on the Witch's Cave. Guys, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. This has been Ren Dog playing Minecraft Survival. We will see you in the next episode, my lovely friends. Goodbye.